7 days a week, man chop. Hey everybody, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we will be talking about the Toyota Mark X. The reason why I chose this specific car for this video is because it is one of my favorites and it has a lot of history behind it, and it is a very questionable car here in Jamaica. A lot of people don't know the potential behind the Mark X. Them just see it and them look on it as a hype car or a scammer car, and there's way more to a Mark X than just yeah, you look good or a scammer car, girls like it. But there is way more to the Mark X than that. And before I start this video, I just go and give a shout out to O'Neill. I'm gonna put him YouTube link right here. So he was the one who did the art for me of the Mark X, and he also has merchandise on cars. And respect to all of the car lovers out there. Also, I really want to thank everybody who support me with my video them. I should have done this at the end of the video, but yo, I'm really grateful. I want to thank everybody who say yo, Javon, do it. And believe it or not, enough people say yo, I'm proud of you for making this a movie and start your own channel. You see me? And I just want to say yo, thanks and enough respect. A lot of people don't know that the Toyota Mark X actually started as a Mark II, or it is derived from the Corona. Mark II Corona. Yeah. I'm going to start from the fourth generation because I couldn't find any information on the first generation, Mark II, second, and third. It's probably out there, but let me want to make this video as compact as possible. The Mark X, we all know, started out as the Corona Mark II. It was released in 1980 with the lineup consisting of a four-door hardtop, a four-door sedan, a three-finger disc, four-door sedan, and station wagon. And what happened with the Gen 4, them discontinued the two-door. So actually, them used to have two-door Mark II. Imagine one two-door Mark X. That would have taken up. In 1984, the fifth gen Mark II was born, and they brought back the station wagon. Guess what? It came with the legendary 1GEU inline six. Engine, you guess, you're smart, you know, you're smart. And also, there was a turbo version. Like, once mere turbo, my mind just go wild. I love it. Turbo, I love it. The sixth generation, this is my favorite. The sixth generation Mark II is my favorite because my father used to have one when I was probably 2 up to 4. I used to live with my father, and yeah, I don't remember much, but then, but like, I could remember saying my own car. I remember saying it sounds sweet, and like, I just know I grew up and like, me hear them car. I start to hear Mark II again, and I say, yo, that sounds sweet. And like, up till now, me in love with the Jay-Z sound, me in love with the 1G sound, me in love with the RB sound. And the people who know me know something like BMW, but BMW sounds sick. It's 6-cylinder BMW, them sound sweet. Not straying from the topic, this legendary Mark II was released in August 1988. All the gasoline engines for this model generation were double overhead cam and 24 valves. The main engines that came in this machine, my officer machine, because a machine, general a machine, were four. Why am I doing this? Four. Were 4 2-liter inline six units, including a twin turbo 1G. GTEU and a supercharged 1G GZE. I would have liked to drive on Supercharged Marco. That would have been so sick. 3 4-cylinder engines. Like when I woke up on this 4-cylinder part, like I did so disappointed. But then I got to understand that the 4-cylinder that came with the Mark II were diesel. So you have a 4-cylinder diesel, which is 2.4 liter, which was naturally aspirated. And there was also a 2.4 liter turbocharged 4-cylinder for this car. Like, we don't know what this is with naturally aspirated people, like turbo. Like, if you can't afford to go turbo is sweet. The sounds, trust me, the sound of a turbo in your car, like, it's just worth it. It just make, it change your whole experience when driving. Driving one normal car on the road, like, you just want to get from point A to B. You see, any day, you put one pipe by your car, like, I'm not telling you to go straight pipe your car because that's illegal, but put one sweet sounding muffler on your car. You see me, especially if I stick, because like, people with Matic car with load muffler, they tend to just want to make up one bag of nice, don't do that. Put one pipe on your car if I stick, and trust me, your experience go totally different. Like, you know people who just don't shift, like, them are gonna stop and them just go down on brake and then go on clutch same time and then just stop, like them not heal on two and go down. Like, well, me can't heal on two, but like my rev match when me a gear down. And like, trust me, it sounds sweet, it changes your whole experience when driving. It make you actually love, like, our lifestyle, our culture. You see me? Cars are a culture. I'm straight again. Let's move on to the Gen 7. The 7th generation Mark II was released in October 1992. They were divided into two types, the Sporty Tourer and the Luxurious Grande. The two were differentiated by the interior, the exterior, the suspension settings, and the steering settings. Oh yeah, I never mentioned, like, why I love all of them carrier, apart from that them are 6-cylinder and them sound sweet and them come with the 1G and 1J and even 2J. Them are rear wheel drive. Like, back. You ever drive a rear wheel drive? Like, you take kind of different. Like, yo, I'm not gonna cry. Yo, my love car differently. You see, rear wheel drive, I want totally different experience. And oh my god, the Gen 7 also came with the 2JZ, the 2JZ GE, and the 2JZ GTE. Or you have an option of getting a 1GFE. I want 2JZ all the way. The 8th generation was released in 1996, just 3 years before Javon was born. Javon Brown, ever heard of him? He's a legendary guy, like, awesome. It was basically one Gen 7 Mark II with one new body, one facelift, and like the only difference was like everything. Like, it come with all of the fancy stuff, like ABS, which is anti-lock braking system, dual front airbag, side airbags, VSS, vehicle stability control, and you had the option of getting a 2-liter inline 6, 2.5 liter. And they were both naturally aspirated, or you could get a 2.5 liter turbocharged inline 6 and a 3 liter. The generation 9 was produced from October 2000 to October 2004, and that was a sedan, the sedan version. And the station wagon, what you find is, like, from the generation 6 coming up, like, them no make station wagon for them. I don't know why. And like I have a thing for station wagon now. When you sit on a station wagon and you put on like some offset wheel on it, like just to look at it. Like, me not talk about performance. Like, if you want your car to look good, get a set of coilovers, get a set of wheels, get your right size. You see me? Don't get big old rims with some tint on your leg. Focus on what the function of your car is. If you want going to racing, if it's a daily driver, and then you have different tires for different things. And like in future videos, hopefully we can get into those type of stuff. What kind of tires you should wear for what purposes. And in Jamaica we don't have snow, so obviously you're not gonna need snow tire, but like you need multi-purpose tires. If you do street racing, there's a special tire. If you do drag racing, there's a special tire. There's not much drifting going on in Jamaica, but if you're doing drifting and like burnouts, you need a special type of tire for them something. Isn't it? This car, the Gen 7, came both sedan and station wagon. And the options in engines were the 2.0 liter 1GFE, the 2.5 liter 1JZGE, the 2.5 liter 1JZFSE, and the turbocharged. Right when anytime you're turbo mother, well, I love turbo, and the turbocharged 2.5 liter 1JZGTE, the 10th generation. There isn't actually a 10th generation because what happened, them discontinued the name Mark 2 and like 10 X and 10 same thing, so them just call it the Mark. No, they don't call it that. It's the Mark X. The Mark X was introduced in 2004 and it has been a big deal. Big deal. In Japan, it was the top level car sold at Toyota store locations. The Mark X has a loyal group of enthusiasts. We need to learn to pronounce that word. People all over here, yeah. From the Mark II, you have people who actually call it Mark X. People who call it Mark X, and like we there, we just look for a Mark X and we're like, yo, what's going on here? But people actually call it and have it as their price card. And the powertrain for the Mark X, like, I've been dying to get here. The first generation Mark X was equipped with the 4GR FSE V6 with a 2.5 liter pushing out 212 horsepower. Sounds small, but trust me, it big. It is stock. That is stock. And a supercharged 3GR FSE pushing out 315 horsepower to the wheels. With the wheels stock, and they came with the option of a 6-speed automatic, which only come with the rear wheel drive, and a 5-speed auto with the all wheel drive. The second generation Mark X featured the 2.5 liter 4GR FSE V6, which pushed out 200 horsepower, and the 3.5 liter, I love this, 3.5 liter 2GR FSE pushing out 316 horsepower, and the supercharged 2GR FSE pushing out 355 horsepower. Stock. The GRMN, enough people don't know about the Mark X GRMN. Probably you hear about the Mark X GR Sport and you have the Mark X GS Sport. The GRMN, and this means the Gazoo Racing tuned by the master of Nürburgring, Mongo, is a limited edition. Only 100 were produced in 2015 and 350 in 2019. They came with a separate rear and front bumper design from all the other markets then, which was shared also with the GR support. Weight reduction and 19 inch BBS wheels and all the good stuff, all the good stuff. A 6-speed manual stick or Mark X was stick. Oh god, don't cry, Java, don't cry. 6-speed manual with a limited slip differential, like all of them simply make me excited. Sport tuned suspension, high performance brake, and additional chassis reinforcement. Production of the Mark X ended on the 23rd of December 2019, last year in Japan. Like this is so sad. The Mark X stopped making, with a total of 6.9 million cars sold since the Mark II was born. 6.9 million Mark II and Mark X himself out of Japan. Not to mention China make Mark X too, and like me not add that the number there. Just Japan alone sells 6.9 million Mark X, and like we just there. Oh, Mark X, like nobody don't care. It hurts. The final edition was produced in 2019. It was produced with 18 inch aluminum wheels, dark plated. I don't want to cry. The front bumper and the back bumper were black and red. The interior was finished with Alcantara and leather. This car, I get some sad music and put right here, so we can actually do that. I should do that. Like, this car marked the end of the Mark II lineage. Like, this is the end of the Mark X. We might never ever get a new Mark X after this. And you know the thing? Like, Jamaica, the bad Mark X, them, we not get them. Like, we get Mark X cool, and we not tune them. We have them stuck and we run them stuck, and trust me, we are dominating the road with them. But imagine if one Jamaican actually got up and choose to actually tune the Mark X run, or actually buy one GRMN or one GS or one GR Sport. Guys, we have some amazing cars out here, and we are make waste of them. Like, more encourage somebody out there who are watching this video who have a Mark X, keep it, don't sell it. You might want to sell it, but the Lord told me to tell you don't sell it. You see me? Hold on for your Mark X, take time and tune it. You see me? Buy built parts if you have to buy it. Shipping one GRMN engine. You see me? Somebody must crash a Japan and have the engine for sale. This car has a whole lot of potential. You see me? Way more than what we are seeing. And it is such an amazing car. And if I even want to mark to them, me I go get my hand on one day. Guys, thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the subscription bell so that you don't miss the opportunity to watch any of my videos that I put out. And like, share, subscribe. Thanks, guys. Thanks a lot. So tired of the straight line, and everywhere you turn, there's vultures and thieves at your back. Storm keeps on.